I think my whole experience playing hockey has really shaped the person I am today from these past 4 years and all of the years before that that I've played. I think I'm probably always going to carry that competitive spirit that I've developed because of hockey, and I think it's just the mentality of always wanting to do the best you can and just that determination and perseverance that hockey teaches you is something that I think I will carry with me for the rest of my life.
Like, in terms of figuring out what my feelings are about this journey coming to an end for me, I don't think I've really started to process it quite yet. I'm sure there will be tears in the last game, but hopefully that's not for a while. Just, I'm so grateful to have been given these extra 5 years of hockey that I didn't think I was going to have after high school. So literally every second here is a gift, and if I just keep playing like that, there can't be any sadness. It's all happiness and looking on to the future.
Game she had, tipping home a goal in the last one these two teams played.
Okay, we're going to get up to it, get after it, pressure their knee right off the hop here, be hard on pucks, let's win lots of races, be physical in our defense, and we got to get pucks to the net with traffic. Okay, we're going to start with Serena in net. Woo! Davison and Bird on the back. Woo! Tegan, Tuck, and Chinner up front.
York Lions and the Ryerson Rams getting the pleasantries out of the way and getting ready to line up for the faceoff here in the first period of this game. York has had some trouble getting out of their own zone, but York Lions is 5-on-5 in front of the net! And Vilt doesn't know where it is, but she's got it nonetheless, and this game remains 0-0.
Again, Ryerson has been having a lot of chances here in the first period early on, but Serena Vilt is strong so
Lauren
far.
Nicholson across for Kraus in front of the net and scores! Brooklyn Gemmel puts it in and the Ryerson Rams are up 1-0.
Now this period was all Ryerson. They had a lot of chances in front of the York net.
Green with it again. Skates to the center, lofts a shot in, and it's in! Krishanda Green flicked one to the center of the net. And she has the Rams up 2-0.
York, sorry, is definitely gonna have to look at their stars to make some magic happen. Otherwise, this is gonna be a Ryerson game.
In front of the net, puck in front, and they score!
Washer picking up her fifth lead.
Nice job by York to get on the board and cut this lead in half.
And the back pass, and it results in a 2-on-0 here. And fanned on the pass, a golden opportunity.
And a goal for the Rams.
And the Ryerson Rams take a 3-1 lead now. Getting that goal from York right back.
And that one's
off the falling Carolina Eagles. Back in front, score! York Lions are staying in it and making this game 3-2. It's another one goal game. Tipped in there, another 2-on-1. And that one was deflected, but a penalty is going to be drawn here as the York player is down. And it's gonna be Laura Ball taking a penalty here.
Definitely need to take advantage of this power play if they want to tie the game.
Is one back to St. Cyr. She makes a move at the line and throws the lock in front of the net. Carl Washer has the goal, and this game is tied 3-3. York, a breakaway here. Score!
What an odd What a change in the game.
And it's Courtney Gardner throwing that one through the legs of Benny Bichon. And it's 4-3 for New York Lions.
No, Ryerson is probably thinking going into this game that they would take home the win, that it would be an easy game. But York is proving to be a tough opponent, especially in these last period as they have taken the lead in the game 4-3.
Plays it back to Hines. Hines fires a shot. We see an empty cage here at the Ryerson end. It's all in time for that. Shot right at the front of the net, and a mad scramble in front. A little bit of scrappiness, first time we've seen in that game, but standing strong in net. Just on side of the Rams, and with 4 seconds to go, the York Lions are gonna win it. The Ryerson Rams, maybe not the outcome they were looking for tonight, but definitely what you want to see if you're the York Lions finishing their season strong.
Fittingly, you know, the last YouTube episode of Overtime was called Adversity. And tonight we had a lot of adversity. We didn't start the way we would have liked. Obviously, we're down 3-1 at one point. But you guys fought through the adversity and found a way to get better every single period and get it done. You know, battling through injuries, battling through penalties, battling through everything. Like, that's a gutsy win, and I'm proud of you guys. Way to go. Awesome. So that's a big thing, right? Like, we talked about this as a playoff series, these three games, like Wednesday, Friday, Saturday. Tomorrow's the most important game. It will be the toughest game. You are going to be tired. They're going to be fresh. We have to be mentally tougher because your legs will be fine. But you got to tell your brain, hey, we got to do some work and we got to grit this out and we got to play tough. And they're probably going to ice the puck all day and try and win races. So we need to be ready for that. I'm okay with that. And we just have to be gritty like we were tonight. Proud of you guys. Way to go. Let's finish strong here, okay? Who's getting Rory?
Well, I want to make a few mentions. I think, Steffi, you played really well and you worked hard and you spoiled them. And Pau, I thought you played really well as well. And Walker, two goals, so, but I've got to give this to Serena.
Every single game that I've played in my last year, whether it be at home or away, I've always said to myself, even if it was a home game against Waterloo, it's like, this is the last time I'm going to be playing Waterloo in this arena, so give it your all kind of thing. Even when I went to away games, it was the same thing. Like, this is the last time I'm going to be playing in this arena. The whole year I've known that, and I've been, you know, knowing it's going to be coming to an end, so I've been trying to play every game like that.
I think coming into my final games, it hasn't really hit me yet that I'm almost done my hockey career here at York. I feel like that's going to be more of an afterthought once the moment comes, then it might hit me, but until now I'm just enjoying it.
Once it came to the last few games, there was a lot of talk about, oh, how are you feeling? Like, are you sad? How are you feeling? And it honestly didn't really set in. Even the day of the last game, it didn't really set in until I walked into the change room and the girls did a great job and decorated the room and made it feel extra special for us grads, so thankful for them for that.
You see it?
Yes!
What, now?
Oh, it's good, it's good.
Now
I'm straight.
How do you do that?
Where's the
mouse
over
there? Oh.
Full screen that bitch.
Said we're here for a good time. Not a long time.
Not a long time.
So have a good time. The sun can shine every day.
We love you guys, and we just wanted to make today super awesome. And I don't really want to talk anymore because I don't want to cry either. But let's get a dub and have a good time tonight.
Welcome to OUA TV here at Canland Ice at York, where we have the final game of the season for the York Lions against the Laurentian Voyageurs on graduation night. Tonight we'll see Cynthia St. Cyr, Tegan Duncan, Steffi Samuel, Chelsea Tucker, and Captain Jenna Gray in their final game in a Lions uniform for the rest of their career.
Hockey will never, ever disappear from my life. The next stages definitely won't have a center on hockey for me, but it's always going to be a foundation for my happiness. And whenever I need to get back to my roots, the ice will always be there for me. I will always be here for the girls and coming out to support games and just continuing to be a part of this family that's given me so much.
I know I'm going to leave here with deep friendships with people that I didn't ever think that I would ever meet. So, you know, the games are fun and the practices and the workouts, but it's even like those little moments that don't seem like they mean a lot. But when you look back, all the fun that you had in those little moments is what you're really gonna miss.
When I think back to my goals, I think I really did grow a lot as a person this year, as cliche as that may sound. I think I've learned so much just from the experiences of this year and all the adversity that we've had as a team. I think I've grown a lot from that, so I really value every experience that I've learned from this team.
And it was kept in, says the referee, by Aaron Locke. Laurentian is on the puck now, turning it over for Locke. Here's McLennan, her shot tip, it scores! It looked like it was Taylor Murphy on the tip. McLennan did a great job of getting that shot through the crowd in front of the net.
I definitely think that the team isn't heading in the right direction now. I'm heartbroken to be leaving at this stage because I can see such an amazing trajectory for where the team is going to go, and I just wish I had some more time to be a part of that journey. But I'm definitely proud of the work that me and the other fifth and fourth years have done.
To St. Cyr, who sends it across to Aaron Locke. She circles that top. Jenna Gray tried to tip the puck and bats at it now, and it's in the net! Kara Washer down low, along with Jenna Gray, just batting at the puck.
So I think that the future is definitely a bright one, and that we're knocking on the door right now.
Pass in front, the shot doesn't get away cleanly. Davison tries to clear it, and that does it. A 2-1 win for the York Lions here on graduation night over the Laurentian Voyageurs. Great. Frantic finish to that game, and exactly the way you want to end the season for York and the way you want to end your career for the five graduating players. That marks the end of the season for the York U Lions women's hockey. We'll see you next year.
Well done. You know, excellent job. I wish we had more to play because it seems like we're just getting into the stride now, but well done. Grad Day is always a bittersweet day because it's the end of a great journey, and it's awesome when we can finish with a win and allow the seniors to go out in style. And I thought everyone contributed so much today to help have a great game, and I thought each one of you really battled hard today. I think the seniors have made an amazing impact on this program. I wish we could have had a playoff game for you guys to reward you for the hard work that you've put in, but I know you've left this program in a better place, and we're going to reward you by getting there next year and make you proud. And I look forward to the work that has to go into that. And, you know, I said it last year, how much I love coaching and how much I love you guys in this room. And you challenge me in really good ways. And you challenge each other. And I just can't wait to see what we're going to do moving forward. So, who's Rory going to?
I think it's very exciting being part of the next generation of the team because they have set down such a great culture and they did a lot to implement the kind of ideas that we want on our team. So we're able to continue to like grow onto WANU and like being a family, but also having the same skill set and continue to be a championship team.
I think that what makes me the most positive about this coming year would be how everybody is bought into the game plan and the message we want to send. What the graduating players left this year is a great stepping stone for us next year and the years coming, because we have what they taught us and we can just grow that from here on out.
I think we're moving into next year and kind of taking over that role of the people who graduated. I don't think it's a matter of replacing them. I think it's a matter of continuing to pave the path that they started, and they started a legacy that our team will become that championship culture that we talk about, and I think being able to continue that for them, they would love to see nothing more than the team to continue in the direction that they wanted it to go in.
I'm really honored to have learned from them and be able to carry on this culture and make them proud, because whatever we do in the future, whatever we achieve, they'll be a part of that and we'll have them to thank for that. And I'm just really excited now that we have such a great culture established to see what we can do.
So are we all done?
Yeah.
I'm here.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's good.